Good afternoon, students. In previous class, we have seen some molecules about cyclic compounds in IUPAC nomenclature. After that, I gave some examples for the homework also. Okay, further today, how to write the IUPAC names of those homework problems we will see today. Let us see what are the given molecules and how we are going to give the names of those compounds. Let us start with that one. First compound is like this. They gave the compound. This is bond line representation. Already I told that if you have seen this type of thing, see here carbon, here carbon, here also carbon is there, here, here, everywhere points. Those are representing carbons. Okay, ma. Directly we can give the name, or if you feel any little bit confusion also, we can convert into normal compressed form and we can write that one. Okay, let us see how we will write CH3, CH2, CH2. CH3, CH2, CH3, CH2, CH3. This is our compound if you write in the form of compressed form. Okay, now first thing we have to take parent chain. From this, how we are going to select parent chain? Let us think that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 carbons. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 carbons. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 carbons. All are getting equal possibilities. Okay, here, if you take any sort of parent chain, all are same only. See, if you take this one as parent chain, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This has parent chain. Ethyl group and ethyl group are side chains. If you take this one as parent chain, ethyl group and ethyl group are side chains. So if you select any sort of parent chain, we are getting side chains same only. That's why anything we can select it as parent chain. Now I am selecting the parent chain like this. After selection of parent chain, give the numbering. From left to right or right to left, we are getting same numbers. That's why I am giving here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. On third carbon, we have ethyl and ethyl group. Okay. From here, if you give 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. On third carbon, only ethyl and ethyl groups are present. Then both are same only. So I give from here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now the name of this compound is on third carbon, ethyl groups 2 are there. Correct. Then 3, 3. Diethyl pentane. Parent chain contains 5 carbons. Parent chain contains 5 carbons. Root word pent. All are single bonds only, ane, pentane. Okay, 3, 3, diethyl pentane. This is the name of first compound. Those who wrote the names of these compounds, observe whether the molecules you wrote correct or not. Second molecule. This is the second molecule they give. Okay, cyclohexane molecule, normally I am representing like this. This is nothing but CH3, ma. This is nothing but CH2 CH3. Is it okay? Now, if you start from CH3 carbon here, what are the side chains first? Methyl group and ethyl group. What are the side chains? Methyl group and ethyl group. If you start from numbering here, 1, 2, you will get least numbers. We have to give numbering in a way that whether that is anticlockwise or clockwise, the side chains must get least numbers. Like that, first onwards we are following. Okay? So from here, 1, 2. If you start numbering from here, 1, 2. In both the numberings, we are getting same positions. In previous numbering, we are getting methyl group first position. In second numbering, we are getting ethyl group first position. Okay, when two side chains are present, those two side chains are getting same numbers when we give from anti-clockwise or clockwise direction. Like that. See, this is anti-clockwise. 1, 2. Like this, we are following anti-clockwise. If you start from this carbon, 1, 2, clockwise. Okay, in anti-clockwise or clockwise direction, we are getting same numbers for methyl group and ethyl group. Then, in open chain compounds, what is the rule we followed? Alphabetical order. Here also, same alphabetical order we can follow. According to that alphabetical order, ethyl group will be first preference, methyl group will be next preference. According to that, ethyl group must get least number. Because ethyl E starts with E, methyl starts with M. First letter we will get EMA, after that M. That's why we have to give importance to ethyl group and it must get least number. According to that, I am preferring clockwise direction. Then 1, 2. Remaining numberings, no problem because remaining side chains are not there. Na? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. If you have side chains, then it is important to give numbering remaining. Correct or not? Here, no side chains or substituents are present. Na? So, simply these two carbons, if you give numbering, it is enough. Now, what is the name of this compound? 1 ethyl, 2 methyl, cyclohexane. One ethyl, two methyl, cyclohexane. That is the name of the second compound. First compound 3,3 diethyl pentane. Second compound 1 ethyl, 2 methyl. On first carbon, ethyl group is there. Second carbon, methyl group is there. What is the rule we follow for open chain compounds? Same rule we can follow for closed chain compounds also. Is it okay, ma? Now, this one will become 1 ethyl, 2 methyl, cyclohexane. Okay, next we will go for third compound. Before that, observe the compound names carefully, all of you. This is the compound they give. Now, selection of parent chain. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Like this, straightly I am taking the parent chain. In that way, I am getting 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Like this, also I am getting 7 mark. Okay, here we are getting two possibilities. In those two possibilities, which possibility we have to select? Okay, for your clear understanding, I am writing this compound, okay, in the compressed form. Is it okay? Let us see. Start with this one, CH3, CH2, CH, CH3, CH2 CH CH2 CH3 same this compound I wrote it as compressed form. Okay, now if I select this one as parent chain, how many carbons we have? Observe, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 carbons are there. Correct? Now, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. This possibility also, we are getting 7 carbons. When we have two parent chains getting different side chains, no? With same number of carbons. Those two parent chains are containing same number of carbons. I took one example from textbook and I explained number of side chains and number of branched chains we have to write. In those two possibilities, which one has max number of side chains, that one must be selected as parent chain. Like that we told that rule here we have to follow. Now I am going to take one more possibility also here. Okay, let us see. CH3, CH2, CH, CH3, CH2. CH, C, CH3, 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 CH2, CH3. Okay, now if I select this one as parent chain, what about the condition? See the number of carbons, ma, all of you. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Here also we are getting 7 carbons. Here also we are getting 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 carbons. Now I am going to count the number of side chains and number of branched chains in every possibility. Okay, let us see. Here this chain is there, methyl group. He is directly bonded to parent chain. 1. This is also directly bonded to parent chain. This side chain ethyl group, ma. This ethyl group is also directly bonded to parent chain carbon. 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 side chains we have. 0 branched chains. Four side chains, 0 branched chains. Then coming to this possibility, this is side chain, okay. This is also side chain, but these two are there. These two methyl groups, those are not directly bonded to parent chain. Correct? Those are bonded to side chain. Then this is one branched chain, this is one branched chain. Here we have two side chains, two branched chains. Two side chains and two branched chains. When this type of condition we will get? When we have two possibilities, same number of carbons with different side chains. When we have two possibilities of parent chain contained by same number of carbons with different side chains. If you have same side chains in like previous compound, anything we can select. Here, like that we cannot select because according to this, we will get one name. According to this, we will get another name. That's why we have to select one name correctly. Is it okay, ma? Now, this is selected as parent chain because it has four side chains, zero branched chains. This one has two side chains and two branched chains. So the possibility which contains maximum number of side chains, we have to select. The possibility which contains maximum number of side chains, we have to select. According to that, this one is selected as parent chain. This is not selected as parent chain. Okay. According to this parent chain, what is the name of this compound? We have to give numbering now. Numbering from this side automatically. We will get second carbon side chains. Here, from if you start this side, third carbon we are getting side chain. So clearly, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Numbering was completed. Now, on second carbon we have methyl groups, third carbon ethyl group, fifth carbon also methyl group. Then alphabetical order, 3 ethyl, 3rd carbon, this is ethyl group, okay, 3 ethyl, remaining 3 are methyl groups, ma, 2, 2, 5, 2 on 2nd carbon, 2 methyl groups are there, so I am mentioning 2 times, 2, 2, 5, trimethyl heptane. This is the name of this correct. This is the correct name of this compound. What is this name? 3-ethyl-2,2,5 trimethyl heptane. 3-ethyl-2,2,5 trimethyl heptane. Because on second carbon two methyl groups are there. Here fifth carbon one methyl group is there. So according to that, three methyl groups are present, in which 2, 2 times I represented 5. 2, 2,5. Trimethyl heptane with third carbon ethyl group. This is the name of this compound. Observe this carefully. Why didn't we select this one? And why we have selected this one? Clearly it was mentioned. This probability contains 2 side chains and 2 branched chains. This probability contains 4 side chains and 0 branched chains. We have to select the parent chain which contains max number of side chains. According to that, we have selected this one as parent chain, and according to this, we give the name of this compound. 3-ethyl-2,2,5 trimethyl heptane. Is it okay, ma? Shall we go to next compound? Okay, note down neatly all of you. These are all important only. In next 12th class, nomenclature is also useful. Highly useful in organic chemistry. 4 important chapters are there. Volume 2 mainly organic chemistry in 12th class. So you have to concentrate on this one. You have to pay high concentration here. Next compound. This is simple only. Selection of parent chain. This is parent chain. Parent chain contains how many carbons? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 carbons are there. Okay. Now we have to give numbering. Left to right or right to left? Left to right we have to give. Because left to right, if you give 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 2, 3, 6, we will get side chains. Ma, side chains number I am writing. If you give left to right, we will get numbers 2, 3, 6. If you give right to left, 2, 5, 6. I hope you are habituated how to give the numbering. Okay. Left to right, I took the numbers. I represented the side chains numbers. Those are 2, 3, 6. Left to right. Right to left, 2, 5, 6. First numbers are same. Least numbers only. First numbers are both the same least numbers. Then we have to go to next number. 3, 5. In that, which is least number? 3. That possibility we will select, and right to left numbering we will cancel. It is wrong method. Then what is the correct numbering? Left to right we have to give numbering 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Left to right giving numbering was given. Now this compound name is 2nd carbon, 3rd carbon and 6th carbon we have methyl groups. 2, 3, 6 trimethyl 15 2 comma 3 comma 6 trimethylheptane, that is the name of this compound. This is third one. Next, fourth one. That is the compound we have, fourth one. Now, Seema, 1, 2, 3. At this junction also carbon is there. 4, 5, 6. If you take straight chain, we are getting 6 carbons. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We are getting 6 carbons. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Here also we are getting two possibilities of same number of carbons present in parent chain, 6 carbons. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This one separately we will discuss. Now I am going to rub this one also. Okay. Let us see that how we are going to give the name of this compound. This compound, two possibilities I am writing, CH3, CH2, CH2, C, CH2, CH3, CH3, C, CH3, CH3, CH3. This is the same compound. Okay, next, one more time I am writing here, CH3, CH2, CH2, C, CH2, CH3, CH3. First, if you select this one as parent chain, if you select this one as parent chain, how many side chains we have? This is total one chain, 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 side chains we have, 0 branched chains. Correct? This total chain is directly bonded to this carbon, parent chain carbon. This is 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 side chains are there with 0 branched chains. If you select this one as parent chain, please observe both the possibilities we are getting same number of carbons. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 carbons. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 carbons. But the difference is, we are getting different number of side chains in branched chains. See, this one has 4 side chains, 0 branched chains. This one has, this carbon is directly bonded to parent chain carbon. 1. This is side chain. 2. 2 side chains we have. These two are branched chains. 2 branched chains we have. Out of these two possibilities, which one we are going to select as parent chain? The parent chain which contains max number of side chains we are going to select. This one, 4 side chains are there. This is correct, this is wrong. Then according to this, what is the name of this compound? We have to give numbering. Anyways, from here on it is better. Because on second position itself, we have side chains. So, least number, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. membrane was completed. Next, on second carbon, methyl groups are there. On third carbon, methyl group and ethyl group is there. So I'm writing here 3 ethyl 2, 2, 3 trimethyl hexane 3-ethyl 2, 2, 3 trimethyl hexane. That is the name of this compound. 3-ethyl 2, 2, 3 on third carbon ethyl group is there. This is CH2CH3 ma ethyl group. Okay. Second carbon CH3CH3, third carbon CH3. 3, 2, 2, 3 trimethyl 3-ethyl hexane. Alphabet clutter. Ethyl and methyl. E will be first. So I wrote E will be first. 3-ethyl 2, 2, 3 trimethyl. This one no need to write. This is the correct name for this compound. As it contains, this possibility contains 4 side chains and 0 branched chains. We are going to select this one as parent chain. Is it okay, ma? Next we will go for next compound. I hope you are clear, everyone. The students who wrote the names, okay, once observe and correct the names. These are the answers for the given homework. As well as we are like a practicing of IUPAC nomenclature only. These compounds are all, you have to know how to give the names of these compounds. Not only for your 12th class, ma, for your NEET, the students who are going to appear for NEET exam next year, for them also it is highly useful. NEET and IIT. For that also IUPAC nomenclature is very important. Definitely one question will be there. One or two questions will be there from IUPAC nomenclature for NEET and IIT. Okay, next one. Fifth compound. This is the compound they gave. Now I am writing the compressor form. CH3CBr CH2 CHCH3 CHCl CH3. This is the compound, same as this. This compound I wrote it as compressor form. Okay, here I am going to select the parent chain. This one is parent chain. Okay, after selection of parent chain, we have to start numbering. Left to right, if you give numbering. 1, 2, 3, left to right. If you give numbering, bromine is getting 2 position, 3, 4, 5. CH3 is getting 5th position. Chlorine is getting 7th position. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Sorry, no, 6th position. Chlorine is getting 6th position. Right to left, if you give numbering, chlorine is getting 2nd position, 1, 2, 3. Methyl group is getting 3rd position. Br is getting 6th position. In both left and left to right and right to left, Br is getting 2nd position, chlorine is getting 2nd position. Okay, what is the rule? Alphabetical order we have to follow like that. But the problem is, when we have no methyl group here, when no methyl group is present, we have to follow alphabetical order and we have to select bromine as the least preferred one. Means it should get least number, not high preferred one, it should get least number. left to the right we have to give memory. But here methyl group is also there. In this condition what we have to do? Okay, select the methyl group is getting also least number. See ma, bromine is getting second number, methyl group is getting fifth number, chlorine is getting sixth. Here bromine is getting sixth, chlorine is getting second, but methyl group is getting third position. Okay, chlorine is getting, substituent is getting second, along with that methyl group is also getting three, least number. Correct or not? Here alphabetical order we should not follow. We should not follow alphabetical order because only two substituents are present, chlorine and bromine. Both are getting same numbers. Then alphabetical order we have to follow. Bromine must be getting least number. According to that we have to give numbering. But the thing is here, along with bromine and chlorine substituents, side chain is also there. That is methyl group is also there. That methyl group is getting different numbers. Left to right, that methyl group is getting fifth number. Right to left, that methyl group is getting three number. Okay? So, in this possibility, substituents are getting least number to first one, as well as methyl group is also getting three, least number. Are you understanding, ma? When we have no methyl group, then definitely we have to select bromine as the high preferred one and it should get least number. Left to right only we have to follow. But here methyl group is also there. It is getting least number from right to left. That's why I am selecting right to left as the correct one. Left to right is wrong one. I hope you are clear everyone. In both the conditions, if you get methyl group same position, then there we will follow alphabetical order. If methyl group is present here, ma, 1, 2, 3, 4. If methyl group is present here, we will get left to right and right to left, methyl group same position. Then there, all the positions are same, na? Then we have to follow alphabetical order and left to right we have to give numbering according to bromine. But here, if you take right to left, CH3 is getting least number. That's why we are following that one only. According to that, we are going to select right to left numbering only. Please, once again, I am clarifying that here we have methyl group at least position right to left. Third position. That's why I am selecting right to left when compared to left to right. When methyl group is also getting same number, here 5, 3 different numbers are there. Na? When methyl group is getting same numbers in both left to right and right to left, then alphabetical order must be followed. But here different numbers we have. So in that which is least number for methyl along with substituents least numbers. That one I selected already. See 2, 2 same only. Next number only I selected. Methyl group which is getting least number. According to that this is the correct way and this is the wrong way. Is it okay? Now the name of this compound will become 6-bromo. 2-chloro, 3-methyl, 6-bromo, 2-chloro, 3-methyl, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, heptane. That is the name of this compound. 6-bromo, 2-chloro, 3-methyl, heptane. Please observe all of you once again. I took left to right possibility and right to left possibility. Left to right, I am getting bromine second position, methyl group fifth position, and chlorine sixth position. Right to left, I am getting chlorine second position, CH3, methyl group third position, bromine sixth position. As we are getting right to left and left to right, bromine and chlorine same positions, as well as methyl group is getting least number in right to left method. That's why I am preferring right to left numbering. That's why I didn't select alphabetical order. If you get methyl group also same position, ma, then we have to select alphabetical order. Is it okay? This is about name of this compound. Finally, the name of this compound is 6-bromo, 2-chloro, 3-methyl, heptane. Those who wrote according to that alphabetical order, please correct, ma. Okay, now next compound. Sixth compound. This is the compound they give. Okay, now I'm writing compressed form CH3 CH2 CH2 CH CH2 CH3 CH2 CH compressed form I wrote. Okay, now observe the parent chain, all of you. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 carbons we are getting. Okay, next. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Two possibilities of selection of parent chains we are getting. Then side chains, branch chains, count we have to see. So two possibilities I am writing. Those two possibilities are CH3 CH2 CH2 CH CH2 CH CH2 CH3 two times I wrote the molecule, same molecule. If I select this one as parent chain, if I select this one as parent chain, one side chain, two side chains, one branch chain, two side chains, one branch chain. Coming to this one, if I select this one as parent chain, we are getting same number of carbons. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now, this is side chain. This is also side chain. This is also side chain. We have three side chains, zero branch chains. Three side chains, zero branch chain. Here we have two side chains, one branch chain. According to these two, which one is selected? Already you know. The parent chain which contains maximum number of side chains must be selected as parent chain. This one is parent chain. Correct one. This is wrong. According to this, what is the name of this compound? I am going to rub the wrong one. I hope you are clear, everyone. Now we have to give numbering. Numbering from this side I am giving, because second position we are getting methyl group. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, on which position ethyl groups are there? Third position ethyl group, this is ethyl group. Fifth position also ethyl group. Okay, second position methyl group. Now 3, 5 diethyl 2-methyl. On second position methyl group, 3, 5 diethyl 2-methyl octane. 3,5 on third position, ethyl group is there. On fifth position also ethyl group is there. 3,5 diethyl 2 methyl octane. 3,5 diethyl 2 methyl octane. That is the name of this compound. I hope you are clear, everyone. Okay, we have here two sites, so two branch, sorry, parent chains. Here in this compound, we are getting two parent chains with same number of carbons, different side chains. So we have to see that the parent chain which contains maximum number of side chains must be taken as main parent. Actually, that is the parent chain, correct parent chain. So this parent chain contains three side chains and zero branched chains. Previously, I selected one more possibility. Thus, that possibility is containing two side chains and one branched chain. Okay. So out of these two, this probability is correct. So I selected this one as parent chain. If you select this one as parent chain, then numbering must be given from this side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, like that. On third position, we are getting ethyl group, and fifth position ethyl group. 3,5 diethyl 2 methyl octane. That is the name of this compound. Okay, this is sixth compound. We will see some more. Actually, I gave so many compounds, man. Okay, we will continue those compounds in the next class. By today's class, I hope this is okay. Okay, the students who wrote the homework, once check the names of these compounds with your written ones. If any mistakes are there, small mistakes might be present. Definitely, I will agree with that one. Okay, correct that one and understand the concept correctly. Okay, ma'am. Thank you. Thank you, all of you. Have a nice day.